It is not cronyism, the technical term. Cronyism is development of threats. It is there in modern politics, it is there in modern business industries, it is there in organization, it is there in labor industry, it is there in all industry locations. It is there known as a crony monopoly and crony capitalism. It is there in the society. Even the monopoly of the market, even the capitalistic structure of the market is on the basis of this cronyism. What is cronyism? As per the definition, they used to say lenience, intelligence, silence, patience, and license are the various executions of this cronyism. If you are giving a person, allowing a person to do something, that is known as lenience. Intelligence is to have an extended allow. If you allow a person to do something, that is lenience. If you have a timeless, boundless permission for a person to move upon his own interest, that is known as intelligence. If somebody is doing something, even though if you are feeling inside, if you are keeping yourself quiet, that is known as patience. If you don't feel anything at all, that is known as silence. You are also participating, you are the main person who has instigated that, that is license. So these five things are the major wings of this cronyism that is existing now, and more than bribery, if bribery is just 25% corrupting the society, 75% of the society is corrupted only by cronyism. All the people are friends, relatives, and beneficiaries. Nepotism, cronyism, these things are the major aggregates of the society. By which everything is done. Is there? Recently there was an issue about Paul Wolfowitz, when he has created some office of the Secretary of Defense for his friend who is not eligible. Even Harriet Ware, who has been appointed in the Supreme Court of US by George Bush, he is not having any judicial experience at all, which has been totally protested by media and all the revisions of the nation recently. So we have innumerable things, and to mean a lot of things from our India, we have to publish an encyclopedia of nepotism as well as cronyism from our society. In order to maintain the dignity of the nation, and to maintain also silence for lot of secular reasons, we have to work from various countries and their exemplifications. So this is the question of the society. And religion and spiritualism is not exempted at all. Whenever something is given to God, without thinking that we are giving just what He has given, number one, we are not thinking that we are just offering with utmost humility something which He has provided to us as a token of gratitude. That is not there, number one. Number two, we consider there is religious justification and divine pardoning which has liberalized the people, the religious people, that God will excuse anything. And this is known as religious corruption. Whenever you think that you are giving something, number one, whenever you are offering makes you to get or demand prominence of yourself before God, number two. Number three, whenever you are thinking that any of your social mistakes, only religious mistakes or some sort of primitive mistake that you have done as a previous imprint of your extra birth can be forgiven by God. All the other things you have to undergo, punishment, rectification, repression, and some sort of rejuvenation by means of spiritual exercises. Whenever you think that you are giving something, whenever you are demanding prominence in the holy structure of God, whenever you think that you can justify or reconstruct everything by means of divine offerings, that is spiritual corruption, that is theological corruption. So, theologically, concept-wise also we are corrupted, practice-wise also we are corrupted. And this has been told in the Western industry as simony. It came from some Simon commission which was made on the basis of the various clergy mismanagements that have been administered in the extra century churches. It came into existence, it is known as simony. Utilizing offices of clergyship, sale of offices, sale of authorities, sale of positions, and demanding something for baptism, absolution, marriage, burial, confession, etc., and which is not there, left in our Hindu temples also, mismanagements of funds, misallocation of funds, and fake jewels are misplaced in the place of real jewels, all the lands are confiscated by people. This is also there everywhere, and there is also a recent revolution against the fatwas which have been issued by the provocation of some bribery and backdoor entry that has come in the Muslim system also. And baptism certificate, people, they are also bribing the people for getting those certificates sanctioned. So everywhere, because God is pure, man makes the industry of God and himself impure, and also pass on that impurity to everybody whom he meets. So that is the greatness of the human contribution to religion itself. So the synonymy is that. Apart from this synonymy, we also have dynastic politics. In all countries, it is the dynamic qualities. It has not been exempted at all. In all countries, we used to have. Recently, Sri Lanka, you know that there is a Mahindra Rajapakse. And Guho Rajapakse is his relative who is just a retired army officer and he is the Secretary for Defense now. And there is Shamal Rajapakse, his brother, he is a minister. There is Basil Rajapakse, one more brother, he is also a minister. So it becomes, say, according to the Shastra that you have to treat the nation as your home. It does not mean that you have to treat like this. Four members are the ministers. And India has its own precautious and precious record for dynasty politics. The various other industries used to see that. So this dynasty politics, not only there in Cuba, Greece, Venezuela, Vietnam, wherever you see we have political corruption, dynasty influence, we used to see everywhere. It is common. Political corruption is the base of everything because they are the watchdogs. They are the mothers who have to feed the nutrition of the rice and duties of the citizens. They are the fathers who have to admonish the people and admonish them in the pathway of righteousness and justice. They are the teachers who have to bring us knowledge. They are the guardians, they are godlike people. That's why we used to say, now Vishnu Prithvi Patihi. The ruler is no more different from Vishnu, that is the God. So they are the God representatives. Now they are reciprocated from the term God. And this political corruption, it has entered in, number one, brutality, suppression of the opponents, political vendetta, and the core of it is kleptocracy. Kleptocracy is the rule made by the thieves. So there must be a distribution between the thieves and the rulers. At one final stage, one final dawn, there the diaphragm between the thieves as well as the rulers that vanishes, that becomes kleptocracy, and I think that we are facing that in some other direction. And Panama has been given the name, the country Panama has been given the name, narco-kleptocracy. The type of thieves who are basically substantialized by narcotic drugs and the immoral trafficking and smuggling, that is a major industry of Panama administered by the rulers of Panama, not by some other non-state actors. It is known as kleptocracy. Why kleptocracy flourishes? Because of foolocracy. If somebody is elected with a fool, then the elected people will be only thieves. And the fools will be going to face the evil, illicit consequences for the wrong selection or for the silence at the time of wrong selection, for discarding elections, for not emphasizing their vote rights and vote values. So this is also very much important. And what is this effect of corruption? Corruption is cyclic, like vicious circles of poverty. Corruption is also cyclic in nature. Corruption, it improves more corruption. More corruption that creates a galaxy of unworthy people. Unworthy people, they give qualityless services or services of adverse effects. This will create only self-embezzlement, creating untold miseries, victimizing the poor and innocent of the society as a whole. Inefficiency and distortion will rule the society. The cost will increase like anything. All of the other public allocated funds will be diverted as capital projects or capital funded projects which can be easily managed. Everything will be covered with complexity so that we have to approach the officers so that the right transaction can be effectively done. Increasing of complexity is also done. Quality reduction, everything will come in the form of budgetary pressure which will be coming on each and every human being's personal brain as well as the skull. It will be inscribed on the skull of your future generations. So it is the greatness of this cyclic, momentary, as well as everlasting, as well as total incumbent study and structure of this cruel bit of poverty that we are going to face as a result of this corruption. This is the type of corruption which is very dangerous in the nature. So this corruption should be taken with various steps from various levels.